Hello, fellow architects and design enthusiasts. Welcome back to Architutors. In today's tutorial, we'll dive into the fascinating world of parametric design using Grasshopper 3D and Rhino. Buckle up, because we're about to create some mind-bending geometry. We'll go through a Grasshopper definition to create a parametric design of a chandelier. First, let's start by creating a spiral curve in Rhinoceros. Choose vertical axis. We can edit number of turns in this geometry and let it also be in a conical shape. Now let's also rotate the curve by 180 degrees. Right now, it has a few too many segments and points. So type the command rebuild curve and edit its point count. Press OK. Make sure you have the gumball option on, and we can move the points to change the shape of the curve. If you're a learner when it comes to Rhino and Grasshopper, then make sure to subscribe our channel as we come up with some really helpful and interesting Rhino Grasshopper tutorials. These curves look okay, and we can take it to Grasshopper. Meet our secret weapon, Grasshopper. This visual scripting plugin for Rhino. First, insert the component curve, right-click on Set One Curve and select the spiral curve we created. Add component divide curve to divide the spiral curve into a number of points. Define the number by inserting a number slider. Insert line SDL component and a negative vector component. Enter a Z-axis component to define the direction of the line. We're trying to create geometry on the points we defined to make it into a chandelier. Enter construct domain component. Add a range component. Now we can define the value of the domain. We can set different values that will create a magnifying and diminishing effect of the geometry. Next, add a box component that will be replicated to all the point we defined. We can define the depth of the boxes by adding a number slider. To change the height, we can add a graph mapper and set it to different graph types to achieve different results in parametric design. We can change the curve geometry and the value on number sliders to get different results. Generative design is like having a magic wand, just wave it, and voila, shapes appear. And at last, we can bake this parametric geometry into Rhino. Thanks for joining us on this parametric design adventure. If you enjoyed this Grasshopper and Rhino tutorial, hit that like button, subscribe to Architutors, and share your creations in the comments below. Until next time, keep designing, keep dreaming, and keep pushing the boundaries of what's possible. Happy parametric designing. See you next time.